Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. I don't know when this is going to air. This is probably going to be one of the more ambitious videos that I do, but today I am going to make the frame and the mold for a fence post that looks like that, and then we're going to pour cement in it and see how well it works. So not going to do much talking, mostly just going to be watching me work. Enjoy. And if you like how this turns out, and I think it turns out well, once it's fully done, I will post the full description and a PDF of how to make it below. To fix that guard. Thank you. video might be cut short due to that. That was beautiful. You know, I get all the tools out, but do I remember to use them? No. So a little commentary right now. My original design, I'm going back to more standard, so this would be an 8x4, and actually a full 4. But I'm questioning whether I want to leave it as an 8x5.5. Thank you. and there's the rain. So that's it for this section of the video. I will be back while I finish redesigning this, and we'll go from there. Thank you for joining. Alrighty, the storm has let up a little bit, so I'm gonna try and get a few more cuts in. I know you are all thinking this, but nobody's said it yet in the comments because I haven't given you the chance to. John, why don't you clear out a spot in your shop? And then you wouldn't have to keep running in and out when it gets raining out like this. Well, the short answer is that is how much junk is actually in my shop right now. And there's so many other projects in there, it's not worth the effort. Plus, this leaves the mess out here. So, in between raindrops, I work on all my messy projects out here. And yes, eventually I will have the shop open to projects again, hopefully before winter comes, but you never know. Now, the second question some of you might be asking is, why are you ripping the board? Well, I do have a table saw and I could use that, but it's buried in there, and I'm going to be using the skill saw a lot more, so just use that. Now, other question of why am I ripping the board is because I want it exactly 4 inches for this mold. You could change the size, but I want these to be exactly 4x8, so that's why I'm doing that as well. while we're at it, I'll cut this section out and make a separate video, but how to use a chalk line. So I measured 4 inches right there, and I made a mark. Came to the other side from the same side, measured 4 inches, made a mark. And then as you saw, I'll do it again. I take one end of the chalk line and hook it onto that so that the chalk line is right there on the mark. Then I will drag it down to this side, keeping it nice and tight. You can see how that first line was off. But now I'm directly on that mark. While keeping and maintaining pressure, you will snap it. And now I know to stay on that line. So the bonus of doing it this way is now the uncut one, unripped one, can be my end. So, which one do I want? Probably should, and I think I just mentioned this, but I eventually will do a whole video on choosing wood. That doesn't look too bad. Use that end. Perfect. Alright, so let me cut two pieces out of this and then clean up for the day because it's starting to rain again. Ain't that a joy? Alrighty, I'm gonna call it a day since it's raining out, and we'll get her started again tomorrow. The next part shouldn't be too hard. It should just be screwing that all together and then making the internal sections of the form, and then we pour.